Yep. Back out. And this time, I'm in the picturesque Cheviot district. Look at that. The forecast is for like lovely weather, clear skies, sunshine, a little bit breezy overnight, nice clear skies. But I think there's a big moon, so that might scupper any chances of star lapses and star shots, whatever. But yeah, heading up there. You might recognise it. This is the hill me and Mr. Stoker bailed out of. We're bailed because of the weather. I'm not bailing this time. Got my solo tent. Just me on my own. Just finished work. Didn't feel very good at work. Felt a bit weird. So put a half day in. Still feel a little bit odd, but pulling myself around, get a bit fresh air. It's probably what I need. And this will be the last camp for a while because of the second lockdown. How long that lasts, hopefully it won't last too long. But yeah, I'm gonna set off. Just come up a right steep bit. Right. Gained some good height. There's the car park. You come up the side there. All right, and then this bit's steep. And I mean, look at the views. The weather's forecast nice. Like it's turned. It actually has turned out how it said it was going to. For now, just gotta go up there to crest that. Whew. I parked there. Just using just a little one here because I've got to go to work in the morning. Boo. I don't have to go in dead early, but I've got to be in for at least 9 o'clock, so I'll be up sharp. Maybe catch a sunrise. Who knows what will happen. That's the joy of these camps, isn't it? You just don't know what's going to happen next. Look at the colors are lovely. Autumn colors. I think a lot of people have this down as their favorite time of year for the colors, especially photographers. Colors are just amazing. I mean, the green in summer is lovely, but the different shades, brown and some of the trees stay green, they make for good pictures. Like, I'm just seeing the distance right at the top of there is Braden Crags. That's a bit too far. I've got to get back early tomorrow, see? That's why. That's a good little plan B. Right, I'm good far to go. Just up this bit. Just get my breath back. So we're all set up. The pot. Take them off like this. And there is another 600, so that's 3 litres of water. I think I'm gonna be glad of this tonight. It's freezing already. Got a Wayfarer's pasta bolognese and chocolate pudding if I desire it, I don't know. Two different bobs in there for a chocolate milk. Down coat. It's actually quite tidy in here for a change. Now, you may notice there's something missing. There's no beer. Just have a night off, you know. I'm just here to take a bit of time out. So, and because I've got to go to work tomorrow, I've got to drive early, so I'll not be drinking anything. It's gonna kill us. It'll be a test of my willpower, because I haven't got anything. There's no way I can get a drink. It's not gonna kill us, like, is it? I wouldn't normally drink on a Tuesday night anyway, so there's no spoiling. Just might get a bit bored, that's all. The lads aren't here, so I think they're all working. The last minute decision to come out, so I thought, nah, the hell with it. Just sneak this last one in before we're locked down. Hopefully this won't last long, you know, a month. It's not gonna kill us, is it, a month? That's a bit of a pun in there somewhere. So I think what I'll do is get the kettle on, warm up. The sun's going down behind us there. But I don't think I'm gonna be able to capture a sunset. I'll try, I'll have a walk up and have a look. We'll just drop down off the top. It's blowing a gale, as usual. It's windy. Windy Tuesday. It's blowing gale up there, so I came down here. I might be a little bit broadside onto the tent, but it's all right. When you're inside here, it's mint. You wouldn't think it was windy at all. So that's all right. So that's it. We'll just have a bit muck about. Just come up on the top. Sunset's a bit of a no-show. It's a bad cloud, that bank of cloud there is spoiling it a bit. Let's go up the top here. It's another one of them Bronze Age Roman forts. Another one goes in a big circle. A few of them up here. This was made by the Romans in the Ice Age to keep the Scottish out. That's about it really. But the Neanderthals came again and just wrecked it. Just knocked it all down. They knocked it down and they built this great big wall somewhere. Shame about that sunset. Sky might go a nice red colour, but not gonna see the sun go down. Not to worry. Hopefully the skies will clear up like it said it was going to. Yeah, it's blowing a gale up here. 20-30 mile an hour forecast. So what I've done is, I mean, on the top there's loads of space for tents if it's not windy. Yeah, even if it is, shouldn't really be letting the wind bother with. But I've dropped down out of it, a little bit out of it. I'll come down to here. Just at the edge there. It's out of it, but it's still, somehow, it's coming over the top of there and straight down into that valley, you know? There's no shelter there, like, I might as well have been on the top. Yeah, it's a shame about that sunset. Dart on top of the Cheviot. It's always got a cloud hat on, the Cheviot. There's the shill with the great big stones on the top, braid and crags. This is Easter and Wester Tors, Newton Tors. I think that's Easter Tor, that's Yeverin Bell. All these hills are still to explore. Right. Absolutely freezing. I'm Baltic. I'm gonna have to put my down jacket on, I think. This is what warms you up. Oh, I needed that. Whew. Just a quick one to say thanks to everybody who's donated to buying us a coffee, beer. It's up to it's up at like 60 odd quid now, which is amazing. So thanks to everybody for that. Some people have put their names on, but the ones who have, I'll be thanking you personally. What was I going to say? I was going to do it, I wasn't sure whether the cancer research or Macmillan, but Macmillan seems to be the one. I asked a few of my mates, they've been raising a bit of money for them lately. Macmillan is probably the charity that needs it the most, isn't it? So we'll do that, we'll get that donated. At the end of the month, I'm going to do that, so I'll do a little video to show how much I've made, how much I'm sending. I had 20 odd quid in the PayPal account anyway, but I'll just leave that in, just send that. That's my donation. So everything that goes from my PayPal account, I hope they don't take fees. They better not take fees, PayPal, it'll be hell on. Imagine that. If they do, I'll just make them. Nice, so that's it. I'm just gonna have this, chill out a bit. Hope the stars come out. Makes a huge difference. You'd be amazed at the difference that makes. I mean, lots of people will know this already, but if you're just new to it, because it stops all the wind going down the back of your neck. Already I'm feeling too, I'm a bit too hot now, like. It's too warm. But we've stood out in some really harsh conditions and we all have hoods up, you know what I mean? You don't get cold, you really don't. I've never been cold in this court. I've had about 5 years now. Just thinking about stuff I've had for years and years. This is one. I've had this for years. This is why I pay a lot of money for stuff. I've had that. I've had that for 5 years. I'm still using it. Albeit it might need replaced. Well, I don't know, like, there's no wrong with it. 2.5 litre Osprey pack. I used bicarbonate of soda to clean it out. And then you put it in the freezer and all the bacteria, any bacteria that's in, just freezes and it kills it, apparently. I've had this little pouch here. I've had that for about 6 or 7 years. So I still use that. I've gone through some amount of pillows. I've had my waterproof coat, I've had that 2.5 years now. That's lasted a while. This base layer here, this wrap base layer, it costs 70 quid, right? And it's so good. It's like merino wool, but look, it's falling to bits, man. It's absolutely falling to bits. But I still wear it. It's amazing, it's dead thin, but it's amazing the difference it makes. It keeps you warm, it smells nice. What else? Loads of stuff like Delta Pegs. I've had them Delta Pegs for years and years. There's loads of stuff I've had, and I've had it for a long time. This cup I've had it for ages. No, I haven't. This is a different one. It's going down now. But yeah. So hopefully this lockdown's only going to be for a month. That's what they're saying. Then we can get out again. I think you can still go out for walks. So we'll be me and Mark, all the Marks, probably go out for a few walks, keep the fitness levels up, because we're getting quite fit now. Just getting to a level of fitness where we're managing the hills, no bother, and then they're going to lock me down. Amazing. Yeah, anyway, we'll just keep at it. Already. Just joking. Super efficient cooking the pasta in there and the chocolate pudding on that side. Seems to do a trick. I'll put the table up as a windbreak. Just put the pot on the ground. Definitely need a light. And then use the table as a windbreak there. That's doing the trick. Mint. It's absolutely freezing now. The good news is the stars are out. They're coming out, they're popping. Mars over there, got some sketchy footage with the other camera. It's really, really too far away to focus on with that camera. It's not that good. Yeah, but just gonna have this. It's annoying, isn't it? If I come like that. It's boiling away, just let that boil for about, just until you reckon. You can eat them hot or cold, like, so it doesn't have to be red hot. It's better if it is warm on a cold night, though. Yeah. Let's let that bubble away there, as long as it doesn't bubble over. Put it on the grass, so if it does boil over, it's no bother. Stroke of genius, that. Use that as a windbreak. Boosh. Anyway, had me tea. Pasta bolognese, nice. I prefer the chicken tikka, but it was nice. Wayfarers again. The stars are out and it's really, really cold. The temperature's gone right down. So I'm just listening to the radio and just chilling out, really. That's all you can do, isn't it? A solo camp, just chill out. Gives you a chance to sit and think things through and just escape the madness for a while, you know. It's back to work tomorrow. Boo. But it's Wednesday tomorrow, so halfway through the week. God knows what the week's gonna bring. I don't know if we'll be allowed out walking, actually. I think we might have to stay in my areas. I don't know, we'll find out. What the hell. Anyway, probably not do any more filming. I think I filmed too much anyway. But I'm gonna certainly going to attempt to do a star lapse, night lapse. Whether it works or not, I don't know. Still haven't come to grips with the settings. I've not really been practicing. I'll give it a shot. We'll see what happens. Woke up to this. It's early in the morning. Gotta get away, haven't I? Gotta get packed up and that's just a short walk back to the car, which is good. Look at that, man. The high hills around here get a right hammering. It's always worth checking the weather forecast and double checking if you're going high here, because that has been like that all night. Big old bank of cloud. That's up on Braden Crags and the back of it is the Cheviot. So just want to watch out. Sun's coming up, but I think I'm too low, so I don't think I'm going to get a glimpse until it's like right up here, which is going to be about half an hour's time. I'll be away by then. But that night lapse worked all right. Happy with that. So I'm just going to get slow pack. Oh dear, I've got to work. I've I've got to go to work and I've got a big job at Hexham. Anybody going past the A69 Hexham roundabout? It's not there anymore. It's going to be taking the roundabout out, and it's going to be a straight road all the way through. But we're doing the concrete testing there. It's going to take until at least next year before that's anywhere near ready. But I've got to go up there today. Nightmare getting on site. You've got to have all the blooming chevrons on the back of your van. You've got to have your orange light on. You've got to have your induction certificate in the windscreen. You've got to drive up this way. You've got to come out that way. It's a pain in the arse. I suppose that's how they keep you safe. Right. A little look around. Crack on. So a quick one for anybody with who's just bought Delta pegs and don't know what to do with them. I've got a footprint bag off the Namarges, but I think they're pretty much all the same size. Footprint bag or a dry bag, any bag about that big. Get the peg by the, put the point in first, right? And lay it flat inside. Put that one in, same way, down the bottom. That one, same way. Start building them up, stack them up, and keep them flat as you can. Right, it's another one. Keep them flat as you can. So basically, what you're doing, you're putting it in the bag like that, and then that one on top of it like that. See, and then they just stack up like that. That's what I've done there, built them up. Like that, yeah. Keep it as flat as you can. Now, if you keep it flat, it should go in the side pocket of your bag. There. And. Hey! Presto! Takes a bit of practice, but it does work. And. So you're hanging them off the back of your bag, risky dropping them, you know, you won't hear them if you drop them. So Robin Wallace, that's for you really. Just to give you a little idea how I do it. I think I was trying to show it in my loadout video, but I don't think I did it very clearly. Whew, right, I'm packed. That's where I was. Sun just it went up over there. I should have been on that hill. I'd have got the sunrise, but I don't think I would, because look at the bank of cloud. So it probably went and disappeared in them clouds, so don't worry. That night lapse looks good. Put that on. Whew, I'm out of breath. Rushed that way. Right, my car's still there, it's not far away, it's just down the valley there. So I'm just going to set off. If nothing exciting happens, we'll see you all on the other side. If you do go camping, you know, don't go broadcasting it. Keep it under your hat. The rules are there for a reason, you know, they're for everybody, rules. Unfortunately, we'll have to stick by the rules. As much as we hate it, we don't want to get ourselves A, into trouble, B, a bad name, C, I don't know what C is. Make it up. Right, I'm off. Packing away, go, boosh. We'll be back.